This is a newborn skull, and the most striking feature of the neonatal skull is the disproportion between the cranium and the facial skeleton. The cranium is very large in proportion to the face. And this can be understood because for one reason, the nervous system is always ahead of the other parts of the body in development, and because the bones of the face are not yet developed. The paranasal sinuses are not yet developed, and the teeth have not yet been erupted. The development of the teeth and the development of the paranasal sinuses will result in a great increase in the size of the face. The bones, especially those bones of the vault of the skull, they are not tightly attached to each other. And there are large gaps between these bones. And the largest of these gaps is located here at the bregma. This is the site of the anterior fontanelle. And you can also notice that the frontal bone is in two pieces here. And between them is the metopic suture. Posteriorly, here at the site of the lambda, is the site of the posterior fontanelle. Those fontanelles are covered by fibrous tissue, and they will ossify later in life. By the second year of age, they are ossified. Those gaps in between the bones help in molding of the skull that takes place during its passage down the birth canal. The presence of the fontanelles in the baby also permit the continued growth of the brain to take place in an expansible compartment. Premature sutural closure can have adverse effects on brain development. Clinically speaking, the presence of the fontanelles enables the physician to determine the progress of growth in the surrounding bones and also enables the determination of the degree of hydration of the baby. For example, if the fontanelles are depressed, they indicate dehydration. And also they indicate the state of intracranial pressure. A bulging fontanelle indicates that there is increase in intracranial pressure. Blood may be obtained from the fontanelles, as well as CSF can be obtained. Another feature of the newborn skull is seen in the temporal bone. This is the temporal bone here, and you can see that there is the mastoid process is not developed. The absence of the mastoid process renders the facial nerve exposed because the facial nerve arises here, deep to the mastoid process, between the mastoid and the styloid process, and the foramen is called the stylomastoid foramen. And this might result in injury of the facial nerve. In case of difficult labor or forceps delivery, the facial nerve might be injured because it is exposed. The tympanic plate is very short. It's in the form of a ring rather than a plate. And this makes the eardrum very superficial. Also, you can see here that the mandible has no teeth. And note the angle of the mandible. The angle here is an obtuse angle. It's not a perpendicular angle like in the adult. So those are the most important differences of the neonatal skull from the adult skull. To sum them up, the presence of wide gaps in between the bones, especially in the region of the fontanelles. This is the anterior fontanelle here. The presence of a metopic suture here, the presence of a symphysis menti in between the two parts of the mandible, two halves of the mandible. The mandible is edentulous and the angle of the mandible is obtuse. The mastoid process is not developed and the tympanic plate is in the form of a ring. And of course, as I mentioned earlier, there is a small facial skeleton in comparison with the cranium. And this is because of the underdevelopment of the paranasal sinuses and the absence of the teeth.